Okay, so now we're going to go through the E major scale, and there are four sharps in the E major scale: F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, and D sharp. And let me just run through the scale for you. Of course, this is concert D. That's the trumpet's E, so the E major scale. This is a fairly common scale if you're going to be jamming with, say, guitar players or other stringed instruments. They like to usually play in sharp keys, so it's a good chance that you'll probably need this if you're in that kind of situation. So this is a good one to learn if you're interested in jamming with your friends or strangers. So here's the E major scale. And I just noticed that the background, my conga is in the back there, and it makes it a little difficult to see my fingers, so I'm just going to move over a little bit so you can see my fingers better. Okay, so there was the E major scale, up and down. Now if we start on the second degree of the scale, we have F sharp Dorian. Okay, this is associated with the two chord, so if you're in a 2-5-1 progression, which is a very common progression in all kinds of music, talk about it a lot in jazz. If you see an F sharp minor 7 chord, this is the mode that you play, the Dorian mode. And so we're going F sharp to F sharp using the key of E. Okay, it's got kind of a minor feel to it. Well, it does have a minor feel to it, not kind of. It's a minor mode. Next up is G sharp Phrygian. And starts on the third degree of the scale, same key signature, four sharps. You know the drill by now, I'm sure. So here we go. Okay. In a 3-6-2-5-1 progression, that first chord, the three chord, would be in the key of E. The three chord is a G sharp minor 7. Okay, so that's the mode that you use. Next up is the fourth degree, the mode built on the fourth degree, and that's Aeolian. Here it is. I think I got that right. Let me do it again. Kind of thought I missed that C sharp on the way back down. I guess I'll catch that in the mix. Next up is an important one. It's the fifth degree, the mode built on the fifth degree. It's the Mixolydian. It goes with a 5 chord or a 5-7 chord. Now, when I'm talking about 2-5-1s or 3-6-2-5-1s, these are shown with Roman numerals, okay? So if you remember, or even if you don't remember, the 5 is a V, okay? It's a V, and usually a V7, so a 5-7 chord. That's built on the 5th degree of whatever key you're in. In this case, we're in the key of E. The 5th degree of the scale is a B, okay? So we're doing the B Mixolydian, or the B7. This mode would go with the B7 chord. And I'm just going to put it down the octave because it's a little easier that way. And probably more people can play the low B than can play the high B. So if you want to take it up the octave, go for it. But here's the low octave. Now, of course, when you do the low octave, you have to kick for that C sharp, because it's very out of tune, very sharp. Next up is another important one. It's the natural minor scale. It's the relative minor to, in this case, the key of A. E. If you weren't confused enough already. So the C sharp minor, okay, C sharp natural minor, is the relative minor for the key of E. And the reason it's a relative minor is that they have the exact same key signature. They're related, right? Just starting on a different note. So here's C sharp Aeolian, or C sharp natural minor. It starts on the 6th degree of the major scale. Okay. Next up, the last mode that we're going to deal with is the Locrian mode. That starts on the 7th degree of the scale. So in this case, that's a D sharp. And it uses the same key signature, the same exact notes. We're just starting in a different place. Here you go. Okay, Now, if you're messing around, like say you're improvising, and you want to improvise in the Locrian mode, it's really easy to kind of shift over to the major, because that's what we're used to hearing, or that's what I'm used to hearing anyway, and it's very easy to shift into that other mode. If you want to improvise in any of these modes, it's a good idea to emphasize the home base note, okay, so the root note. In this case, that's a D sharp, and also the notes that are associated with that chord. So if you're improvising with this, really stress those chord tones and the root note, especially for this mode. And that will allow the listeners, which is including you, to hear that as Locrian. Because it's all the exact same notes as the major six scale, it's easy to hear it as a major scale too, unless you really emphasize those chord tones. Okay? So now let's do the pentatonics. Again, penta means five, so the five notes of the major scale. In this case, we're doing E, so it's 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Okay, that's the major pentatonic. Sounds like this. That's a fun one. The middle valve is down pretty much the whole time. The natural minor also has a pentatonic, okay, so it's the minor pentatonic, exact same notes, it starts in a different place. In this case, it starts in C sharp, same notes, starts in C sharp, and this is what it sounds like. Okay, and of course, that's very closely associated with the blues scale, in this case, the C sharp blues scale. There's only one different note, let's see if you can spot it. Now you might not be able to see it, but I am kicking my slide for that C sharp, D flat. Make sure you get into the habit of doing that. I haven't given you any patterns for these scales. Here's a fun pattern to do with the major scale. It's based on a Clark study, and one of the alternate fingerings for E, 1 and 2, is third valve. So one of the Clark studies goes like this. Okay, messed it up, but whatever, get the idea. The fun thing to do is to change all the E's from 1 and 2 to 3. So it looks like this. Good luck. That one will take a little bit of coordination and a lot of practice to get down. But try it. Have fun. Good luck with your practice.